Dick was the one who said to me, you know, if we can make the love story work, the rest of the picture is going to fall into place. And it really became what Dick would call two kids on a date.
Is it true that you can see through anything?
That's the
stuff. Yes, I can, pretty much. See, I feel like leaving her hung up there. Because
No,
you're not.
Just drift I'm on her face. Okay. She's stealing the scene from you there.
Right.
Don't worry about it. Okay, here we go.
Margo and I were like brother and sister, but we had very, very different styles of working.
Is it true that you can see through anything?
Yes, I can, pretty much.
And that you are totally impervious to pain?
Well, so far.
What color underwear am I wearing?
Oh,
I'm sorry, I embarrassed you, didn't I?
Oh, no, not at all, Miss Lane. It's just that this platter must be made of lead.
So?
Oh, I'm sorry. I should explain. I sort of have a problem seeing through lead.
Oh, that's very interesting. Do you have a first name or anything?
What do you mean, like Ralph or something?
No, I mean like,
Pink.
Huh?
Pink. One key scene. The whole part for me was the balcony scene with Lois, what I call the balcony scene. It's when he flies in and talks to her on the balcony, sort of about who he is. We changed the whole sort of tone of that scene because I felt that it must be, that the time had come when Superman would be open enough to say that he's there because he really likes her.
K-R-Y. Do you like pink?
I like pink very much, Lois.
How fast do you fly, by the way?
Why don't we find out together?
And how do you propose we do that?
Well, you can take a ride with me.
The most grueling part of it were obviously for Christopher and I the flying scenes, which were physically so uncomfortable and often downright painful and tedious and take after take after take.
A couple of times we landed short of the building. So we'd come in for a landing, but drop off the side, just drop out of view. It was hysterical. And other times, they drop us too late, so we kind of went bouncing into the kitchen.
And Christopher felt very strongly about staying in character all the time.
I was 24 and dead serious, with dead being the operative word there, really.
I, on the other hand, got really bored during the flying scenes because there were Chris and I strapped together for 10, 12, 14 hours a day. So I would hide books down my front or try and tease Chris, and he'd be going, shut up. And we would bicker and bicker and bicker, and the poor crew would look away, and they'd go action, and then suddenly we'd be madly in love, and then they'd go cut, and we'd go back to our bickering. And at one point I remember Christopher said, don't you stay in character. And I said, oh, Chris, for God's sake, I've been Lois Lane for a year now, and all we have to do is look left. And he stayed like this.
Flying certainly wasn't romantic to do it, because you're hanging 50 feet up from a soundstage in an extremely uncomfortable leather harness that's cutting into your armpits and your everything else. We'd be whirled back and forth across the ceiling on these wires, and I would be smashing into Chris in midair. And at one point, somebody dropped a clapperboard on the wire and cut off the electric current, and we quickly went whoosh, and we're hanging upside down, held in only by our safety belts. And Christopher actually did this. He reached out in character and held the pole as if he was going to hold us both up from gravity. And afterwards I went, Chris, do you know what you did? And he went, oh yeah. And I said, I think you're just a little too much in character. This is going too far.